One of the challenges with forecasting severe weather and trying to warn for severe weather is predicting those hazards accurately. One of those hazards is hail, and it's very, very difficult to study hail. It moves quickly, it breaks everything it hits, and all of our observations are post-impact. And that can be a problem when you're finding stones that look like this. This is a replica hailstone, but it's clearly been melted. It's got finger grooves that aren't natural. It's rounded on the bottom. And that's because this object modified itself by the time we were able to find it in the field. So we really need a way to observe that in freefall before it has a chance to do anything, which will improve our ability to forecast for it and warn for it in real time. Most people want to know the difference between small hail that's water coated or something like this getting ready to hit your house. And that's why we built the truck behind us, which is a camera-based system that shoots 4K footage at 330 frames a second. And the idea is to capture these stones in complete freefall on their way down before they have a chance to melt or modify. Now, in order to do that, we need a lot of light, because the camera is being exposed for a fraction of a second. So the combined output from the LEDs in this array is about 30% brighter than the sun standing on the surface of the Earth. So you actually need eclipse glasses to stand directly behind it and look at it. It is very, very bright, but it allows us to capture those images of hail and freefall. One of the challenges with building a system like this is making sure that we know that the data is accurate, that we can trust the results. Sizing is easy, right? We can throw things like a baseball or a softball even. We know exactly how big these are, and I can just chuck them through the back of the imager and see what comes out and make sure that that size is accurate. The challenge was velocity. Trying to get an object that's moving at a comparable speed to a hailstone, 80, 90, 100 miles an hour. But that's why we partnered with OU Athletics. With the help of the softball team and the baseball team, those pitchers are able to throw these objects that we know how big they are through the volume at very fast speeds. Baseball was about 94 miles an hour, softball was about 55 to 60 miles an hour. And knowing that and watching the objects go through, we can calculate the velocity using the camera system and find out that it matches what it should have been, which gives us a lot of confidence in the data that we're collecting to know that those results in the field are accurate and representative of what it actually was. After building all of this system, we had to get it out in the field and collect observations. So we've actually been taking it out a few times over the course of the last year. But this spring, we've really dialed that system in. We've had it out and gotten some incredible data collection opportunities. One of those deployments, we were able to watch almost 3-inch diameter stones falling in super slow motion on the way to the ground, watching that impact with the bed of the truck and how it shatters or doesn't. Different stones behave differently. Some are rotating aggressively. Some are melting off water and shedding that as they fall through the environment. Some aren't. And this is all occurring in the same physical space. So for the first time, we're actually seeing results from this system that are challenging some of the ways that we're gonna look at hail going forward. Understanding what it looks like on radar creates more accurate, more timely warnings that can help protect life and property if you're in the path of one of these storms. In the US alone, hailstorms can rack up billions of damage every year. And that's a really big, important factor for insurance companies, building a resilient community that can handle these types of events. Those are all aspects that are going to come out of this research for years to come.